guys, it's Joel here in the Gallucks, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm wearing the absolute, like, the thinnest t-shirt that I have just because it is so, so hot today here in London. Again, probably seen the title of this video already, but let's do a little disclaimer. I am in no way promoting excessive drinking of alcohol. I am no way saying that being drunk is a good thing. It is not. Please drink responsibly. Any of the brands mentioned in this video have nothing to do with the reason why we may have been slightly intoxicated. So please do not take this as a, I should get drunk and go shopping, because you'll see why it's damaging in a second. And you haven't yet subscribed, please don't forget to subscribe. That means so, so much to me. If you are already subscribed, don't forget to hit that bell for notifications so that you know when I bring out a new video. Also, I dyed my hair like a darker grey yesterday. I don't know if you can tell, I quite enjoy it, but it will wash out to that lighter kind of silvery grey within a few days, so enjoy this whilst I can. I'm off to Lovebox Festival tomorrow. If anyone is at Lovebox Festival tomorrow here in London, just come and say hey. It'd be really nice to chat to you. But basically, me and my really good friend Sarah, I don't know if you've seen Sarah on my channel before, she was in my New York vlog, we went to New York together at the start of the year. I will leave a little link to her YouTube channel down below. I think we're really bad influences on each other when it comes to shopping, and then when you throw alcohol into the mix as well, it just gets even worse. So we decided to meet up for lunch because we've not seen each other in ages. I've been away, she'd been away. We went to this really nice Japanese restaurant in central London, it has like a rooftop terrace outside as well. So we had lunch, we had some drinks, and then another drink, and then another drink, and then another drink, and maybe about five drinks down the line, kind of finished telling each other everything that we needed to tell each other, and we were like, I was like, let's go to Selfridges, because it seems like a really good idea. We weren't too far away, we just had a little walk down. We actually stopped, first of all, at Topshop, Oxford Circus, to get some pan and ice. I don't know if you've had pan and ice before, but I'll leave a little picture of it here. It's like rolled ice cream and it is amazing. So then we had a little wander down to Selfridges on Oxford Circus. Don't know if you've been to London before, but it's actually just a short walk away. And then we got in Selfridges, we went to the men's section. Everything Sarah bought was from the men's section as well. I was feeling a little tipsy and it did kind of let loose my inhibitions. I was like, I like that, I'm gonna buy it, I'm gonna treat myself. We also decided to take kind of like a day off. Like, I didn't even post on Instagram on Monday because in our jobs, in like being a full-time blogger, full-time YouTuber, full-time Instagrammer, whatever you want to call it, it is actually quite difficult to take a step back and have like a day where you don't actually do any of that stuff. You know, you don't check everything, every single social media constantly, or you don't reply to every email straight away. So we decided to take a bit of a chill day and then treat ourselves, technically. In Selfridges, we headed to, first of all, to Off-White, the Off-White concession there. And I managed to convince Sarah to buy a new season Off-White t-shirt. It was like a massive oversized white t-shirt with like orange horizontal stripes on the back, and she looked banging in it, I can assure you. And it's long enough so that she could even wear it as a dress. And then I didn't see anything from Off-White because I just got my new hoodie from Off-White. Don't know why I'm pointing there, you can't even see it. So then I took a wander down to the men's shoe section in Selfridges, and there was my first probably downfall. I'm usually a person that thinks a lot about buying clothes before I buy them, especially expensive clothes. Like those Saint Laurent white boots, like that took me a long time to pull the trigger on those. I need to think about it for a very, very long time. Which is quite surprising that I actually purchased these. Here is the bag. You may have seen it on my Instagram story. I posted a little teaser of this Gucci box. I already have one pair of Gucci sneakers, but these are actually not sneakers, believe it or not, even though they're in a shoebox. I will show you what they are. I don't even know the actual name of them. Green Velvet Men's. Let's go ahead and unbox these surprise Gucci things. They're not shoes. Well, they are kind of shoes, but I should probably wear them as shoes considering how much they cost. So I saw these and I instantly fell in love with them. They're actually like slides, but they say blind love on them. I don't know if you can see these properly. I'll show you close-ups anyway. It says la virgule par amour. I literally can't say that, but I know it means blind love because the guy in the shop told me. If it doesn't mean that, I'm gonna feel really stupid. They're basically green velvet slides with red embroidery, and I just thought they looked really, really sick. They were a whopping £235, and when I was a bit tipsy, I was like, that's fine, yeah, take my card. So, Why did I spend £200 on slides? But I love them. I've got a couple of trips coming up in August. Like, I'm going to Lisbon, I'm going to LA, and I just know that I'm gonna wear the hell out of these with socks, without socks, wear them as actual shoes and stuff like that. I actually had to size down as well if you were interested in copying £230 pool slides, which I don't think anyone is. I had to size down in them because the 9s were actually really, really big, so I went with the UK 8, and I will show you what they look like on. The truth, the money never lie. No, I'm the one, yeah. So yeah, that was kind of like an impulse buy because I'd never even seen them before. Like, usually as well, I look at things online and I'm like, I really want that. Like, think about it for a long time, hangs over my head. But then Sarah was like, if you don't get it, you'll probably think about it in a few weeks and be like, oh, I wish I got those slides. And this is true. So I'm really, really happy with those. I'm glad I copped these a little bit under the influence. And then I was like, okay, that's enough for today. And then walking out of Selfridges, I spy, right, so I made a video a while ago about Balenciaga pre-order because I pre-ordered a t-shirt and a sweater, which I was very, very excited about receiving. And then it came to the actual shipping date and I got an email from Balenciaga being like, oh, the sweater that you've ordered isn't available, so we've cancelled it from your order, we're just going to send you the t-shirt. I was like, great, cool. I was away when the t-shirt got sent out because the pre-order was late, so I missed the delivery, so it got sent back to Italy, and I emailed them back being like, oh, like, where's the t-shirt, is it coming back, you know, it's a £195 t-shirt, I was like, when is it getting delivered kind of thing, and they emailed me back being like, oh, we've received it, we're just going to send it back out now, and it's like been 20 days and I still don't have it, so, and also this t-shirt is now sold out pretty much everywhere on every single website. So when I was wandering out of Selfridges with my little Gucci slides, I was like, I'm not gonna buy anything else. Like, I'm clearly a bit drunk. Like, let's just leave. And then, oh, also, whilst I was buying the Gucci slides, Sarah bought a pair of Givenchy slides that she's wanted for so, so long. And then on the way out, walking past the Balenciaga rail, I see the t-shirt that I had ordered online, but I ordered it online in black, but they had it in store in blue. And Sarah looked at me and was like, I was like, should I get the blue? Like, I know I've ordered the black, but the blue looks really, really nice. And Sarah looked at me and was like, you do own a lot of black, Joel. And I was like, that's a bit rude. But this is very, very true. So I decided to try this on in a medium, which was the only size they had left. And funnily enough, it fits like a large. I would say that if you are gonna cop this, go like either true to size because it will be oversized. So, and it was, yeah, it was £195 and it's just got the Balenciaga logo, like the Bernie Sanders kind of thing on it. And I'm really, really happy with it. It's a really, really nice color. Brings out the blue in my eyes. A really good quality t-shirt, which you would expect for £195. So that was also a little drunk splurge that may have happened. But I'm really happy with both purchases. Don't regret anything. Don't regret anything in life. That was like the perfect Monday to go for food. Really good food. Have a few drinks and then go shopping. And then I'll show you what the t-shirt looks like on. No response. Bitch, you blow my heart. That's like turning gold to bronze. Roll my eyes. And when she on the molly, she a zombie. She think we Clyde and Bonnie, but it's more like Whitney Bobby. God forgive me. Don't you ever finesse and I'm a legend. Anyway, that is all I have for you on the drunk pickup side of things. I hope you've enjoyed this video and a little story time. If you are new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe. That means so, so much to me, and I will see you in my next video. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye. No response. Bitch, you blow my heart. That's like turning gold to bronze. Roll my eyes. And when she on the molly, she a zombie.